Steve, perfect segue. Steve Dace joining us from Michigan Podcast to break down Sparty at the Big House against Michigan, or Big Brother, you could say that as well. John O'Korn, of course, in place of Wilton Spate, who's going to miss several weeks at this point, multiple weeks, has been the phrase that's been used, with the soft tissue injury. Steve, your thoughts about John O'Korn, his play to date, and just your evaluation of his play.
Well, Mark, the answer to your question isn't really known yet. This has been a star-crossed career for John O'Korn, and there's been a lot of highs and a lot of lows. You're talking about a guy as a freshman at Houston, threw 28 touchdown passes. That would be a record at Michigan. For all the great quarterbacks we've had, no one's had a 28 touchdown passing season. Gets benched the next year when Tony Levine, who's now the offensive coordinator at Purdue, feels a little coaching heat, changes offenses, puts this young guy in named Greg Ward, who goes on to win a lot of games for the next coach at Houston, Tom Herman, after Levine gets fired. Transfers to Michigan, where it's expected he will replace his former high school teammate, Jake Rudock, at St. Thomas Aquinas. Runs the scout team, red shirts, but then gets beat out by Wilton Spate. A lot of people think we've kind of seen the last of him, particularly when he played one game against Indiana when Spate was hurt last year. And he was pretty much, if my number one option's not open, take off and run. And, well, that didn't work very well. And the offense was pretty brutal in the game that that he played, also in a lot of snow in Ann Arbor. So a lot of people kind of thought his career was over. Many thought he would transfer out this year as a grad transfer. He decided to stay. Word is, in the spring, he got much better. Reports out of Rome, I think I even told you this during the summer, that in Rome, the word was he was the best quarterback in camp at the very end of the spring. But again, he gets beat out by Wilton Spate. And much of the controversy about Wilton Spate's spring struggles centered on him getting beat out by Brandon Peters, the prized redshirt freshman, not John O'Korn. But then John O'Korn reasserts himself in summer camp again, beats out Brandon Peters for the backup spot. We see him in two drives in the Florida game when Wilton Spate struggled. One of them, he led him down to the field for a field goal. The other was a three and out. So we really don't know. And then in the second half against Purdue, the guy goes from bailing out of the pocket to being a magician back there. I mean, he's creating space. He's dodging the rush. He's making throws downfield in terms of athletic broken field plays to blow up the Purdue defense. So I think we don't really know. Michigan fans are hoping what we saw in the second half of Purdue was, you know, there's a history of quarterbacks at Michigan, Mark, that when given up on have come back and won huge. Elvis Gerbach, a lot of people gave up on him when he got hurt. Todd Collins comes in. Gerbach goes on and wins a Rose Bowl. A guy named Demetrius Brown, who once threw 7 interceptions in a game against Michigan State, gets beat out by Michael Taylor. People give up on him. He goes on when Michael Taylor gets hurt the next year and becomes a quarterback that wins a Rose Bowl. John Wengler was a guy that got hurt in a Gator Bowl many years ago against Lawrence Taylor when he got – I mean, people thought his career was over after that hit from Lawrence Taylor. Comes back the next year, wins a Rose Bowl. So, you know, there is a history of quarterbacks given up on at Michigan who do well. Denard Robinson owns almost every total offense record at Michigan. We got beat out by Tate Forcier. People kind of thought he'd never amount to much. Now he, of course, is an all-time record holder at the University of Michigan. So this has been something we've seen a lot. Michigan fans are hoping with John O'Korn we're going to see it again, because that may be the difference between being a 9 or 10 win team and being a team that competes for the Big Ten championship.